Number 10, the seven-headed figure. There is a very strange figure that has been found all across the world, from ancient Siberia all the way to the oldest cultures of India. It's a petroglyph of a mysterious being with two arms, two legs, and seven heads branching out from a very long neck. It was first discovered in the Khakassia region of Siberia. According to the experts, it dates back 5,000 years. And while some claim it has something to do with astrology, it might be something altogether different we can't even hope to comprehend. Let's take a look at the Hindu goddess Manasa, who is depicted as an ordinary woman with a couple of extra arms and seven cobra heads fanning out behind her ordinary head. It may not look exactly the same as the petroglyph from Siberia, but it's the same basic idea, a great deity with seven heads. Moving on to Hinduism, we find beings with seven heads all throughout ancient mythology too. Even the Greek hero Hercules had to slay the Hydra, which is a beast with seven heads. Cultures from Mongolia to Iran all had some kind of monster with the same amount of heads, and they were almost always serpent heads. Even in Mexico, a sculpture has been found depicting a popular deity with seven snake heads. This was found in Veracruz. It's the Aztec goddess of fertility, Aparicio. Even more bizarre is that the figures with their seven snake heads are often female. It's one thing when all these cultures came up with the idea for a seven-headed god. It's beyond coincidence they all chose to make them female. Why? Well, nobody knows. Number 9, the Great Flood. There has been a lot of speculation over the story about a flood washing over the earth. In the Bible, there was a great flood that washed over the earth, causing Noah to build his ark and rescue all the animals. But did the flood really happen? According to a few ancient coincidences, it just might have. The thing is that in almost every ancient culture, there's a story of a flood. And if scholars are to be believed, those who wrote the stories, or at least passed them along, were speaking of an actual flooding event. Which cultures talk about the Great Flood? How about the Egyptians, the Babylonians, the Sumerians, and the Assyrians? The Great Flood is spoken of in the Epic of Gilgamesh, the Hebrew Bible, and the Sumerian creation myth. But the flood is also spoken of in texts from other parts of the world, like in Hindu mythology, in which Vishnu warns the very first man on Earth that there's an impending flood and that he should build a giant boat. But there are even more obscure ancient religions that spoke of a flood. For example, in the relatively unknown yet very ancient Zoroastrian Mazdaism, Ahiram attempts to destroy the world using a drought, and the hero Mithra starts a flood to save the world. But only one man survives inside an ark filled with his cattle. In other words, just about every ancient culture in the world talked about a flood. The consensus is that there probably was one. Number 8, pinecone symbol. Pinecones have been around for a long time, about as long as pine trees. Well, pinecones may be more than just crunchy brown things littering the forest floor. The pinecone also represents the third eye, the pineal gland, and human enlightenment. As hard as this is to believe, it may actually be true. The pinecone has been found all throughout the ancient world and is seen so often and in so many cultures that it just can't be a coincidence. Let's start with the Egyptian staff of Osiris. This artifact dates back to 1224 BCE and shows two serpents spiraling around the center staff to meet a pine cone at the top. There's no mistaking the pine cone symbol for anything else. It's a unique shape and texture. There are also Hindu deities depicted with pine cones. There are countless sculptures in which a deity is grasping what appears to be a pine cone. Then there's Shiva, whose hair is actually coiled in the exact shape of a pine cone. But what do all these coincidences mean? Why is there a pine cone on the Vatican flag and even on the sacred staff that the Pope carries? One of the prevailing theories is that the pine cone really does represent the human third eye and the secret of enlightenment, something our ancient ancestors understood and that we have since lost. What do you think? Is a pine cone just a pine cone? Or is it so much more? Let me know in the comments below, and if you're liking the video, be sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. Number 7, the ancient swastika. Speaking of ancient symbols, The swastika is, without a doubt, the most controversial symbol in the world. It's a thing that, today, represents hate and evil, thanks to that Hitler guy. But long before Hitler ever showed his ugly mug, the swastika was seen all over the planet in different cultures. In Sanskrit, the swastika was the symbol for well-being. It was used by Hindus and Buddhists, and even adopted by the USA pre-World War II. Back when Coca-Cola was still 5 cents, it was advertised on swastika-shaped bottle openers. Did you know the swastika was even used by the Boy Scouts and the Girls Club of America? At this point, you might be thinking the swastika isn't a coincidence at all, since it's been seen in all the same religions from India to Japan. But in fact, there is an ivory figure of a bird in the National Museum of History in Ukraine made from the tusk of a mammoth, and yes, it was found engraved with the swastika. The figurine was discovered near the Russian border inside the remains of an ancient Paleolithic settlement from 15,000 years ago. According to the BBC, experts believe the swastika was seen as a fertility symbol. It's one of the oldest and most widespread symbols in human history, and nobody's really sure why. Number 6. Lost technology. At megaliths across the world, archaeologists have found proof of ancient metal clamps. Evidence of this old and mysterious technology has been discovered at temples, prehistoric monuments, and anywhere ancient people built their structures. The evidence comes in the form of molds that were once used to probably form clamps of metal to help in building. These molds were found in Egypt, Peru, and even Cambodia. The big coincidence is that the same technology has been found at all these random points across the globe. How do we know these clamps were actually used? Well, because their imprints are still around today. There are distinct impressions in the stone at ancient sites that look as though they'd been used to hold huge blocks of rock together. In South America, many of these clips were apparently stolen by the Spanish who thought they were crafted from gold. The rest have been lost, just like nearly all the ancient technologies of the world. Some have speculated that aliens actually came down and gifted this metal technology to all the ancient societies, giving them a jumpstart that would lead to complex cities and structures. With the ability to fix together huge blocks of stone using metal clamps, different cultures were able to make impressive buildings that still leave us in awe. Number 5. Pyramids everywhere. When it comes to ancient coincidences, there's nothing more curious than the pyramid. And while most famous pyramids are of course those in Egypt and the pyramids of Mexico and Central America, there are actually pyramids built in other locations all over the world. Many of the pyramids are built in rows of three and line up with the constellations. There are pyramids in Greece, known as the Pyramids of Argolis. They were constructed sometime between 2000 BCE and 400 BCE. Then there's the Pyramid of Sestius in Italy, crafted in the year 18 BCE. We have the shocking Kushite pyramids in Sudan that were built by the ancient culture of Nubia, with many of them even older than those in Egypt. In fact, there are over 255 pyramids in Sudan alone. Why were so many ancient cultures building pyramids, especially ones that didn't have any contact with one another? There have been pyramids discovered in Indonesia, Peru, Cambodia, and even in Cahokia in the United States. Did all of these ancient civilizations think of building pyramids on their own? Or were they inspired by something that appeared to all of them? Perhaps from another world? What do you think? Number 4. Rome and Rio. Artifacts that came from ancient Rome were found in a bay in Rio de Janeiro. What's really strange is that the Romans never even made it to Brazil. Nevertheless, the artifacts originated 17 centuries before Portuguese explorers ever entered the region. These artifacts were from 2,000 years before European eyes ever saw South America. So what exactly are Roman artifacts doing at the bottom of Guanabara Bay, only 50 miles or 80 kilometers from Rio? Did the Romans truly conquer the world, being the first ones to reach South America? The best theory is that the Romans' ship got lost in the ocean and then sank in the bay, though it is impossible to say whether the Romans themselves ever made it to ground. Underwater archaeologist Robert Marks, who specializes in sunken treasure and early exploration, believes the Roman vessel probably anchored in the bay and then was blown into the reef and destroyed, leaving a small dispatch of Romans abandoned in Brazil. This could obviously have a lot of implications. Did the Romans settle in the area? Did they interact with the natives? And if so, does this mean the ancient South Americans knew about Europe, but the Europeans didn't know about them? It's really quite an interesting concept, and one that's probably true. After all, there were dozens of Roman amphorae jars found. The jars were used for carrying wine and oil on long voyages. It only makes sense that they came from a shipwreck. And it's doubtful all the Romans on board perished just a few miles from the coast. They almost certainly made it to the shore. Number 3. Designer handbags. All across the globe, there are mysterious statues that seem to show ancient cultures worshipping a designer handbag. There are statues from Mesopotamia, New Zealand, and Egypt, just to name a few, with some allegedly going back up to 10,000 years. Now, none of this has been scientifically confirmed by any major scientists, but the proof is still there. After all, you can't really fake ancient statues. But just what is this mysterious handbag seen all over the world? Even more importantly, could it possibly be proof of time travel? The handbags depicted in the statues and motifs are almost always being held by one ancient deity or another. They don't seem to contain anything physical, but they are obviously handbags. Some claim the bags are supposed to contain all the knowledge of the particular god. In other words, cosmic knowledge that is unavailable to ordinary people. This has led some to speculate that the gods worshipped by these ancient civilizations were real, and that they brought secret knowledge with them from the stars. This knowledge, evidently, is contained inside these handbags. Either that, or their gods had somehow traveled to the future and brought designer bags for absolutely no reason. The truth is that we don't know why so many deities of the old world were depicted holding the same thing. It's a mystery that may never be solved. Number 2. Mayan hieroglyphics. Everyone is familiar with the hieroglyphics from Egypt. But did you know that the ancient Maya also used hieroglyphics? In fact, the writing system employed by the ancient Mayans was very similar to what was used in Egypt. The Maya wrote using a system of roughly 800 individual signs and glyphs, drawn out in columns that read from left to right and from top to the bottom. Each word in Mayan represented a word or a syllable, and they could be combined to form any word or concept. These included numbers, names, titles, places, literally anything. The hieroglyphics were often carved in stone or even wood, and they would be found all across the ancient Mayan archaeological sites, written on monuments, on pieces of architecture, and scrawled over walls. The hieroglyphics have even been found on pieces of pottery. The big coincidence here is that the hieroglyphics are so similar to those used in Egypt. How on earth could the Maya civilization have gotten inspired to create their system of writing, which appears to be based on the system of writing used by the Egyptians? Scientists and historians are at an absolute loss. It's such a strong coincidence that it would be as if a small village in China began to write in Latin 5,000 years ago without ever meeting the Romans. It just doesn't make any sense. Number 1. Hinduism in ancient Egypt. The ancient Egyptians were doing things way before Hinduism really became popular. But why does it seem like the Egyptian creation legend is based on the Hindu creation myth? Historians don't know. But there are an awful lot of coincidences between how Egyptians believed they came into being and how the Hindus believe they came into the universe. In both Egyptian religion and Hinduism, before the universe was ever created, there existed only primordial water and no light and no movement. The Egyptians actually feared the world would fall back into this state of darkness. This is why they developed a cult based on worshiping solar deities. If the sun failed to rise one day, Egypt would fall into darkness and chaos. The Hindus believed in something quite similar. They thought the Earth was only going to last for 4 million years, at the end of which the universe would be destroyed and everything would fall back into the primordial waters. The similarities here are that both religions feared the world falling into primordial darkness before the universe. Only the Hindus had an actual date that it would happen. Thanks for watching. How do you feel about the link between ancient cultures? Let me know your theories in the comments, and be sure to hit the subscribe button and come back soon for more videos like this. See you next time. Bye-bye.